the entrance and the fountain. How beautiful upon the mountains are the feet of him brings glad tidings of peace, bearing good news, announcing salvation. Good morning. The Mass this morning is being said for Betty Drury.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You are sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest. On earth, peace to the people of your will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, mighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, mighty God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and glory of God the Father. Let us pray. Lord God, who chose St. Luke to reveal by his preaching and writings the mystery of your love for the poor, grant that those who already glory in your name may persevere as one heart and one soul, and that all nations may merit to see your salvation. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Demas, enamored with the present world, deserted me and went to Thessalonica, Crescens to Galatia, and Titus to Dalmatia. Luke is the only one with me. Get Mark and bring him with you, for he is helpful to me in the ministry. I have sent Tychicus to Ephesus. When you come, bring the cloak I left with Carpus in Troas, the papyrus rolls, and especially the parchments. Alexander the coppersmith did me a great deal of harm. The Lord will repay him according to his deeds. You too be on guard against him, for he has strongly resisted our preaching. At my first offense, no one appeared on my behalf, but everyone deserted me. May it not be held against them. But the Lord stood by me and gave me strength, so that through me the proclamation might be completed, and all the Gentiles might hear it. The word of the Lord. The responsorial song. Your friends make known, O Lord, glorious splendor of your kingdom. Let all your works give you thanks, O Lord, and let your faithful ones bless you. Let them discourse of the glory of your kingdom and speak of your might. making known to men your might and the glorious splendor of your kingdom. Your kingdom is a kingdom for all ages, and your dominion endures through all generations. The Lord is just in all his ways, and holy in all his works. The Lord is clear to all who call upon him, to all who call upon him in truth.
I chose you from the world to go and bear fruit that will last, says the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. The Lord Jesus appointed 72 disciples, whom he sent ahead of him in pairs to every town and place he intended to visit. He said to them, "The harvest is abundant, but the laborers are few. So ask the master of the harvest to send out laborers for his harvest. Go on your way. Behold, I am sending you like lambs among wolves. Carry no money bag, no sack, no sandals, and greet no one along the way. Into whatever house you enter, first say, 'Peace to this household.' If a peaceful person lives there, your peace will rest on him. But if not, it will return to you. Stay in the same house and eat and drink what is offered to you, for the laborer deserves payment. Do not move about from one house to another. Whatever town you enter and they welcome you, eat what is set before you. Cure the sick in it and say to them, 'The kingdom of God is at hand for you.'" The Gospel of the Lord. So today is the Feast of St. Luke. We know that he was the writer of the Gospel according to Luke and the writer of the Acts of the Apostles. He was a physician and a Gentile, but little else is known for certain from sacred scripture about him. Today, St. Paul writes about all his companions who are deserting him, but St. Paul says, "Luke is the only one with me." Indeed, St. Paul and St. Luke were traveling companions. Luke was a comfort to Paul on many occasions, particularly when he was in prison. The love of Christ shared between St. Paul and St. Luke, it offers us a prime example of Christian friendship and what it means to grow in faith and community. In them, we see two friends, who often live out the promise of faithful community promised by Jesus. So given their friendship, I thought it would be good to look at some key aspects of Christian friendship. Pope Francis says that a friend isn't just an acquaintance, isn't just someone we spend our time with. Friendship is something much deeper. Pope Francis gives 5 keys to friendship. A good friend, number one, is that a good friend knows our secrets. Good friends are those that we can confide in and we can open our hearts to. Without the fear of being judged, we can share our joys and our sorrows. Developing a friendship that we can be so intimate with takes time, so we have to commit ourselves to spending time with our friends. Secondly, a good friend never abandons us, like Luke never abandoned Paul. Jesus said, "Greater love has no man than this, than to lay down his life for his friends." Pope Francis insists, when we love someone, We want to be at their side, to care for them and to help them, to say what is on our mind, but never to abandon them. Third, a good friend always defends us. Pope Francis says, it's a great joy to be able to put ourselves in the shoes of someone else, to embrace and forgive them. We all make errors and mistakes, in fact, thousands of them. Therefore, those who can assist others in their errors and mistakes are true friends. Fourth, a good friend doesn't offer you smoke and mirrors. That is, he always tells you the truth. When we're honest with our friends, and we help them realize that true friendship and true love is found in Jesus. Fifth, a good friend gives us strong support. True friendship means giving our friends the best that we have. And our greatest good beyond any comparison is being friends with Jesus. True friendship is rooted in Christ, and true friends help one another grow closer to Christ. So may the friendship shared between St. Paul and St. Luke encourage us to foster the friendships in our lives, encourage us to bring our friends even closer to Christ, and encourage us to grow in our friendship with Jesus. So that with St. Paul, we can know that the Lord always stands by our sides and is always present in our lives, in and through our friends, and most particularly when we receive Him in the Blessed Sacrament.
Gathered together as one community in Christ, we offer Him the following prayers and petitions.
For the Church, may the love of Christ uphold her in her mission of proclaiming the kingdom of God to the world. Let us pray to the Lord. For all nations engaged in conflict, may the Lord bring reconciliation and peace to their lands. Let us pray to the Lord. For those suffering with chronic illness, may Christ, the healer, bring them physical and spiritual healing. Let us pray to the Lord. For peace in our world, for the men and women of the armed forces, wherever they serve our nation, and for the safety of all first responders who serve our communities, let us pray to the Lord. For an increase in vocations to the priesthood, religious life, and permanent diaconate in our archdiocese, let us pray to the Lord. That through the intercession of Our Lady of Prime Succor, may we be spared the loss of life and property damage during this hurricane season, let us pray to the Lord. Those intentions that we hold in the silence of our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord. Our family prayers, prayer for protection and healing from coronavirus. Lord Jesus, you travel through towns and villages, curing every disease and illness. Come to our aid in the midst of the coronavirus. We may experience your healing love. Heal those who are sick with the virus. May they regain their strength and health. Bring those who have died from the virus to eternal peace. Protect doctors, nurses, and healthcare professionals as they help the sick. Allow the vaccine to be successful in halting the spread of the virus. Be with leaders of nations. Give them wisdom to act with true concern for their people. Grant us peace in this time of uncertainty and challenge. We pray this in the most holy name of Jesus, for you are our loving and healing Lord. Our Lady of Prime Succor, St. Joseph, St. Francis Xavier, St. Rock, and St. Rosalie, pray for us. Our family prayer, loving and faithful God, through the years the people of our archdiocese have appreciated your prayers and love. Our Lady of Prime Succor, in times of war, disaster, and death. to you, Father, with Mary, our mother, and ask you to help us in the battle of today against violence, murder, and racism. We implore you to give us your wisdom that we may build a community founded on the values of Jesus, which gives respect for the life and dignity of all people. Bless parents that can inform their children in faith. Bless and protect our youth that we be peacemakers of our time. Give consolation to those who have lost loved ones through violence. Hear our prayer and give us the perseverance to be a voice for life and human dignity in our community. We ask this in Christ our Lord. Our Lady of Concern, hasten to help us. Mother and ready to live, pray for us and we be a holy family.
Lord God, we thank you for the gift of friendship. We thank you for the gift of your Son, our friend and our Savior. We ask you to hear these prayers and answer them according to your divine plan. Live and reign forever and ever. Blessed are you, O God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Through the earth, the work of human hands, will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, will become our spiritual fruit. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant through your heavenly gifts that we may serve you in freedom of heart, we pray, O Lord, so that the offering we make on the feast day of St. Luke may bring us healing and give us glory. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For you have built your church to stand firm on apostolic foundations, to be a lasting sign of your holiness on earth, and to offer all humanity your heavenly teaching. Therefore, now and for ages unending, with all the host of angels, we sing to you with all our hearts, crying out as we acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. From the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread. And giving you thanks, he said a blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." Similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said a blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, from by your cross. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving his holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may be one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Luke, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, Gregory, our bishop, Shireen's assisting bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and all who are pleasing to you in their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil." Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "My peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Lamb of God. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to be taken under my roof, but only say the word that my soul shall be.
Communion Antiphon. The Lord sent out disciples to proclaim throughout the towns, the kingdom of God is at hand for you.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that what we have received from your holy altar may sanctify us and make us strong in faith of the gospel which the Savior proclaimed, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, be with you. Now, Almighty God, bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended. St. Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness of sin. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray, and do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, on our